So today we're going to be fishing on the River Usk, and the method we're going to be using is the Duo, which is where you have a dry fly with a weighted nymph tied underneath it. The dry fly is normally tied either on a standard dropper or New Zealand style, which is when the nymph's actually tied directly off the hook bend. My own preferred method is to tie it on a short dropper, and it's good in conditions like today. We've got a little bit of wind, so the nymph underneath helps anchor the dry fly on the surface for us. And one of the reasons this method's so effective is because not only do you have a nymph, you have the dry fly, so if fish want to come up and take the dry fly, you double your chances that way. And also the dry fly acts as an indicator. If a fish takes the nymph, it pulls the dry fly underneath, and you can see that you've had a take and you can lift into the fish. So because we've got a weighted nymph under the dry fly, we need quite a buoyant dry, and the one I'm going to tie today is this little caddis pattern, and it's a very, very buoyant fly. And you can see on this one I've just tied in a little bit of pink material to help be able to spot the fly on the water. Okay, so I'm going to explain the materials we're going to use in this fly. The first one is the hook, and for this fly I'm using a JMC DR40BL, which is a barbless hook. I'm going to use a blue dun tying silk. For the tail and the underwing, on this occasion I'm using TMCO Aero Dry Wing in straw colour. And you also want some dubbing, and in this occasion I'm using an olive dun, and this is Hertron dubbing, and it's just got a little bit of sparkle in, which I like. And for the overwing I'm using a little bit of elk hair. And for a hackle on the front, I'm using this Grizzle midge cape because I want quite a small hackle. And I've also got a little bit of pink aero wing, so I can just tie in a few strands of pink on the top just to help sight the fly. Okay, so we've tied our dry fly. Now we're going to tie our nymph, which we're going to suspend underneath the dry fly. And the hook I'm using for this one is a JMC DR30BL, which again is a barbless fly. I'm going to weight it with a tungsten bead. I'm going to use a 2.8mm tungsten bead. I'm going to use some of this spiky squirrel fur, SLF squirrel fur, for the body of the fly, and I'm going to dub in a thorax of the Hertron light olive antron dubbing that we used for the body of the dry fly. And for the tail, I'm just going to use a few fibres of this grizzle hackle. Okay, so we've come away from the tie-in bench now, and here we are on the banks of the River Usk at the Glyph Ice Hotel Water. And I'm going to explain a little bit about my setup. As I said when we were tying the flies, the method we're going to fish today is the Duo. And so you can see here, I've got the two flies that we tied this morning. And what I've got is I've got about a 12-foot leader, and then I've got my dry fly, which you can see is on a very, very short dropper, about 2 inches long. The short dropper gives me much better indication. And then about two and a half foot below that, I've got the tungsten weighted nymph. And the idea is, the nymph fish is below the surface with the dry on the top. If a fish takes the nymph, it'll pull the dry under, and that will indicate that a fish has taken the nymph. If the fish are looking up, and I hope that they are today, it'll come up and it'll take the dry, and we'll see that take as the fish comes up and takes the dry. The river's in perfect condition today. It's risen a couple of days ago and it's just falling. And we've got this beautiful bit of water in front of us, and what I'm going to do is fish up the edge of this streamy run here. And that's truly a fantastic wild usk brown trout.
Go safely into the water.
Excellent. So we've had a look at some flies being tied, and we've come down to the river now and we've done some fishing, and you've seen how effective these flies are at catching fish. We've had quite a few fish during this session. But what are the flies? What is it that makes them catch fish? So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go into the river and I'm going to kick up the bottom and I'm going to collect some of the flies or insects that the fish feed on, and I'm going to do a little bit of a comparison for you so that you can see why the artificial flies catch fish. So what we just did is went into the river with the net and shuffled around in the stones to try and disturb some of the insects which the trout feed on. So what I'm going to do now is have a little look at what's in here and collect some out and put them into this tray, and then I'll show you some of the flies from my fly box which I have here so you can make a comparison. So Although we tied two flies to fish up with today, all of the fish that we caught came to the nymph, which is the juvenile or young stage of the adult fly. And this one here is of particular interest to me because it's very similar. And if I put it in there, you can have a little look. It's very, very similar, or similar enough for the trout to take this insect here, or nymph that we've tied this morning. You can see that. And mistake it for food. A small sedge larva, and that's actually the juvenile of the dry fly that we tied today. But if I was going to fish this on my cast, this would be something, although it's a little larger than the natural, would be something that would work ideally. You can see it's got the segmented body, and I've used a little bit of fur to imitate the legs. And this one is tied to imitate the fly as it swims up to the surface to hatch. So I've just used some reflective material to imitate the wings.